That's wonderful. Who else? Chapman, what do you do with the dollar?
I kind of lost it.
Oh. Okay, out of your own pocket, when you get your paycheck, you give a dollar to somebody that needs it, okay? Oh, it was you, that's right. What did you do? What did I give you?
What are the questions?
But what did I give you? How much?
That's what we're supposed to look at.
Oh, well, you were supposed to look at right then.
She said it's $50. I don't touch money.
How many women control the money in their house? Okay, you put it in the offer. Like, well, that kind of defeated what I was trying to do, but that's okay. I wanted you to give it to somebody who saw, like maybe a man on the street or whatever, but that's okay. The idea was to bless someone with it that needed it. And that's what we need to be ready to do at all times, in season and out of season. Let us pray. Father, we pray you would pour out your Holy Spirit over us today so that our ears will hear you, our eyes will see you in each of us, and our hearts will receive your word and your love for us this day as we celebrate you and our church family in renewed consecration, dedication, and devotion to you. We ask all of this in the name of your Son, our precious and mighty Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, if you were listening, you saw in most of the scriptures a lot of judgment. And some of the words were pretty hard, pretty scary. But God also judges with justice and righteousness, as it says in the scriptures. When we read or hear them, we can be frightened and apprehensive, but if we will miss the promise in each one of them. There are promises there if we look. In the last book of the Old Testament, Malachi, the first verse talks of severe judgment, but the second holds the promise that God will also come at the same time as the judgment, with healing in his wings, for all of us who believe in him. Likewise, in Psalm 98, he comes with judgment and vindication. But we are to sing a new song, make a joyful noise, sing praises and use instruments like the lyre and the trumpet to praise him. We are to make these praises even before he comes to judge the earth. He wants us to know that we have faith, we can have faith and joy, for he will judge in righteousness and with equity. In 2 Thessalonians, it tells us how we, the church, need to be. We need to be working with God in all diligence. We are not to be idle, but instead we are to participate in God's work in our family and out in the world around us. Paul says, do not be weary in well-doing. And in Galatians 6:9, the word says, let us not grow weary with well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. Our hands, God's work, is to be a joyous time, a time of gratitude, a time of spreading God's love for others through our work. Lastly, the gospel holds promise too. While Jesus talked about a lot of terrifying things, as Sheila spoke to the children about, in those hard times, in the fearful times, we are to be vigilant and not let ourselves be caught up in these times to be led astray. So many things around us can take our attentions away, and then we tend to listen or follow that way or this way. But we are not to be led astray. Do not let that fear take over. God tells us not a hair on our head will perish. There's the promise. It will not. We will not. Nothing will perish. For by our vigilance and our endurance, we will gain our lives. Our hope and our service is not placed in the physical structures. For though the temple, the church, building are adorned with noble stones, stained glass windows, and offerings, it can be destroyed. I remember when Dennis and I had the opportunity to go to Rome, and we visited Vatican City. That was a number of years ago when I could still walk really well. St. Peter's Basilica was absolutely beautiful, mouth-droppingly beautiful. Even when standing in St. Peter's Square, looking at the basilica and the palace, the opulence was amazing. And the thought occurred to me, it was obvious that tons of money had been spent to create it, and tons of money is being spent to maintain it. The thought was, how much of this vast sum of money spent here could have been used for God's work in the world? This building we call our church home is really not the church. It can be destroyed. No, we, the people, all of you, are God's church, and we carry our church within us wherever we go. We, the church, offer our hands, our time, our resources to further God's work here, yes, but more importantly, outside in the world around us. By our words, by our deeds, we, the church, all of you, reflect God's love for all in our world of influence. So let us do, as Micah 6:8 says, do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with God. And let us answer the call of Ephesians 4:1-3. May we lead a life worthy of the calling to which we have been called, with lowliness and meekness, with patience, forbearing one another with love, and eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. Amen.